okay, but we already know that summation of ni should be summation rho I vi over all I, and that's simply rho times v by definition, which really implies that ni should be given as mi. So I come back to this definition, and rho v I can write as summation ni plus ji. Okay, so this is the relationship between the two fluxes. So if you are talking about flux with respect to a stationary frame of reference, and this is the flux which is the diffusion flux because it's with respect to the mixture speed, average speed, then that's the relationship. So this is the missing quantity between the two. And likewise, you can talk about similarly, I can write down the same expression for ni star as mi star times summation ni star plus ji star. All right, so now we are kind of ready, because we know what the fluxes are, we know what the mass and the mole fractions are, we have already talked about velocities. So we can now talk about the Fick's law. But before I do that, I just wanted to describe to you a term that we will use a little later, and that's called a dilute mixture. Okay. So if we consider a mixture where one component is stationary, okay, so for that component, the velocity of that species is therefore zero, okay, in a frame of reference which is also stationary. And let's say the other component has a very small mass ratio, okay, or you can even talk about mass fraction or the molar density, then that implies that the mass slash molar average velocity of mixture is very small, okay. So what we are saying is that I could either have a binary mixture where there are only two components, or there could be multiple components. But suppose one of the components, the major component, is stationary, and all the other components, they are in very small fractions. Okay, their mass and molar density is very small. Then if I talk about the average velocity of the mixture, that's going to be also very small, okay. And if that is the case, there's really no distinction between ji and ni, then ji is nearly equal to ni, and ji star is nearly equal to ni star, okay. And then it is possible to actually make measurements of these in an experiment, because as you can imagine, if I want to measure fluxes in an experimental setup, and I have to measure the diffusion flux, where I must move and make measurements with the average velocity of the mixture, that's going to be very difficult, if not impossible. But if I can make this assumption that these fluxes are actually very close to the stationary fluxes, then I'm in a good shape and I can make an estimate. So that's how many of these measurements are made. Okay, now we come to the Fick's law. So the law was obviously given by Fick, and the name of the scientist is Adolf Fick, and he gave this law in 1855, and he was trained in physics as well as in medicine. So he was a physiologist actually when he gave this law. So he had to do some experiments which involved some cardiac measurements around a membrane. And that's when he gave these laws. Okay, so you can see very diverse background in science. So he proposed the law for the first time, and in fact this is called the first law of Fick. So he said that J A star. So if I have two components in a mixture A and B. So let me just say that there are two components, A and B, then J A star, he said, is minus rho star d A B times gradient of M A star, and J A, okay, the diffusion flux, the mass diffusion flux, and this is the molar diffusion flux. This is simply given as minus rho dAB times gradient of MA. Okay. So dAB is the binary diffusivity of A in B. Okay, and notice J's are of course the diffusion flux. Okay, and one can also show, although I am not going to show that here, that dAB is actually equal to dBA. So please notice the similarity with the Fourier's law of heat conduction. So there we said, sorry, I should put a tilde here because these are vector quantities. So as far as the heat conduction is concerned, we said the heat flux is related to the gradient of temperature. Okay, and there was a negative sign there as well, and then there was conductivity. Exactly the same law for diffusion, mass diffusion, and what we are saying is that the diffusion flux of mass is actually related to the gradient of the mass flux. Okay, and there is the constant of proportionality which is called the binary diffusivity, and this is a material property, and diffusion of A in B is exactly the same as diffusion of B in A. So having looked at the Fick's law, we now want to use it for looking at the conservation laws, okay, for the mass transfer. So let me write for you the species conservation equation. So we've already derived the continuity equation for fluid mechanics. This is along very similar lines. So I'm not going to give you the proof, rather I'm just going to motivate the equation. So let's consider a binary mixture in two dimensions. So it's a two-dimensional binary diffusion process, and the species are A and B. And we are going to assume that there are distributed mass sources which are going to be named as SMA and SMB. And these are per unit volume. So I'm just going to write down the equation for you. And the equations are the first equation is del MA star by del T plus V star dot gradient of MA. This is d AB and the Laplace of MA star plus SMA star by rho star. So one can derive this equation. So this is in the molar form, but if I want to write it down in the mass form, so the same thing but without the molar averaging, so then I would get terms which are mass averaged plus V dot gradient of MA, and this would be d AB L square MA, and here I am going to get the mass generation term which could be because of reactions, and this would be simply SMA by rho. So this is your general mass balance equation. Okay, this is in the molar form and this is in the mass form. So let's try to identify the terms. So as you can see, this is the unsteady term. That means we are stationed at a certain location and asking ourselves that how does the mass of species A it increase. This is the convection term. So V is the velocity of the mixture, okay, and that is actually taking away MA with a certain speed, the convection speed. So that's the convective transfer. This is the diffusion term, and this over here is the source term. In fact, this equation, as you will see, is very generic. The same kind of an equation we see in heat transfer. Okay, so this is the rate of change of temperature. It could be because of energy that is convected, or maybe because of conduction, or there could be a heat source. Same thing happens with momentum, and now we are seeing the same thing happens with mass. Okay, so if I have a change in the mass at some place, then it could be either because, you know, it's being convected, so either mass is being carried away or some other mass has been brought into that location by convection, or maybe it has diffused out or diffused in. And likewise, there could be a reaction term where maybe there is a generation of mass. How about the boundary conditions? So of course this would need an initial condition, but the boundary conditions would again be of two types. So there could be a boundary condition on the concentration itself. So we could say specify a concentration, and the analogy of that would be, for example, in the heat equation we said the temperature field is specified. Or we could specify a heat flux in the heat equation, and here we could specify a concentration flux. So there could be a flux boundary condition. We are not going to talk about that here. That's a more detailed process, which perhaps you can read up or take up another course where it would be taught in detail. I just wanted to give you the most basic equation. So if we simplify the situation considerably, so let's look at what happens if I have steady state. Then I would get this term goes to 0. Okay. The other assumption is if I have no convection, so I have a pure diffusion problem, and that would imply my V is 0. Okay. I could also have, so this also is essentially a stationary medium. I could also have a situation where there are no sources, and that would imply my SMA is 0. Under those conditions, my equation would simplify to simply del square MA equal to 0 and also del square MA star equal to 0. So this is the simple diffusion equation. And just like heat conduction, just like steady state heat conduction, and also same as the steady state diffusion equation in your Navier-Stokes, if you get rid of all the terms, okay, then the diffusion term actually has this form, Laplacian of velocity equal to 0. Interestingly, the potential flow also has the same equation, but that's a different reason. All right, so let me review what we have done in this small exposure to mass transfer. So I first gave you some examples of where mass transfer is relevant. We looked at biological aspects, for example, in your lungs, okay, where the exchange of carbon dioxide and oxygen takes place in the bloodstream. Then we introduced some concepts of description of concentrations, okay, which is mass based and molar based. Then we talked about the velocities, okay, the mixture velocity arising from the species velocity. Then we talked about the various kinds of fluxes, okay, and once we were used to that, we introduced the Fick's law, okay, which is really something very special and has analogies with heat conduction and so on. And then using the Fick's law, we were able to talk about a mass balance equation, and we identified the various terms which are essentially the unsteady terms, the convection terms, the diffusion terms and source terms, which again reflect the flavor of this course about rate processes. So whenever you have an equation where you have an evolution of a certain quantity in time, so that's a rate process, the question you can ask is, why is something increasing or decreasing? And well, there are these different mechanisms, and apparently they are true for different kinds of processes. So as I said, there's convection, okay, so maybe things are being driven out or being brought in because of a certain underlying velocity field. Then there's this diffusion, and then of course there's a generation term. But if you simplify all this and you only look at diffusion, then the mass transfer can actually be simplified to this simple Laplace equation. So we'll stop here, and thank you very much.